So good afternoon, everybody. Just to start my presentation, I would like to tell you a short story. In fact, it's a story about thermal comfort in TAPS building. I'm sorry, it's maybe not so romantic, but you know it's a technical presentation. So just let's imagine that we are in a TAPS building somewhere, and after a long day of hard work, the building occupant is thinking about his building and his comfort. The question was, I spend most of my time in this building. How I can improve my comfort inside this building? During the day, due to the activity, the temperature of air will rise, and of course, due to convective exchange, the air will climb and will exchange with the cooled ceiling, and the ceiling will cool the air and improve the thermal comfort. Of course, we have also some radiative exchange during the day, where the occupant will exchange with the cooled ceiling, but also with all the other surfaces. So here, we have a TAPS building which is dimensioned to provide the thermal comfort. But the problem is that during the day, the large surface of concrete may reduce the acoustic comfort. So a basic solution, maybe just let's install some acoustic panel. Good solution for EcoFond, of course. But wait, in this situation, and what about the thermal comfort? Because of course, even if we have this acoustic panel, we will still have the convective air movement and the radiative exchange. So the question is, what is the real impact of acoustic element on TAPS efficiency and thermal comfort? And if we know this impact, is it possible to model it? Just to try to answer to this question, in fact, we made a literature review of scientific papers. We used the Scopus database, just to remind that the Scopus database, it claims to be the largest database of scientific papers, articles, and proceedings. And if we look into this database, we can see that we can observe that there is a lot of papers about TAPS building, a lot of paper about acoustic comfort or acoustics, but there is a limited number, to my knowledge, which are focused on the effect of acoustic panel on thermal comfort in TAPS building. It's a very narrow field. But we found some very interesting papers, some of them. Here it's just some pictures of this paper. And what we can see in this paper, some of these papers propose some experimental measurement at lab scale. Some others propose some measurement in a real building, in a real field. Some propose also some thermal model. But overall, we have a limited number of papers. Among this paper, one of the questions was, we have some experimental measurement or experimental results. Is it possible to compare everything? To try to do this, I tried just to take the experimental results from the paper and to compare everything on one graph. So here I decided to use a graph which is from the standard 14-240, which is used to evaluate the capacity of the cooling capacity of ceilings. Here, on this axis, we have the ability of the TAPS ceiling to absorb heat. When it's 100, the ceiling works perfectly. When it's lower than 100, it means that there is something, the acoustic panel, for example, which reduces the cooling power reduction of the TAP. And here, I just plot the ceiling coverage ratio. If it's zero, it's a free ceiling. And if it's 100, it's a ceiling with acoustic panel. And so on this graph, I just put all the data I've read in the paper. So we have a lot of points, very interesting, good colors. And when we see this, we can make some observations. First, we have here, around this value of 60%, a large spread of the value. In fact, it's because here I plot all the data I've found. For example, in this case, we have panels which are very far from the ceiling, around 80 centimeters, which may be far. But here, on the other point, we have some panels which are clustered together in the center of the ceiling and close to the ceiling. So here we have, for the same ceiling coverage ratio, we have two very different effects. So this graph is just a very global and overall view of the effect of ceiling, of acoustic element on the ceiling cooling power of the top buildings. If we try just to make a linear relation between the two, we obtain a correlation coefficient of 0.87, which is not so good, but not so bad also. Just to remind that a very good value of such kind of coefficients, it's 0.99, for example. But here we have a very large view, and this just to give a range of order on comparing all configuration, comparing all experiment, comparing everything on the same graph. We can see that if we cover 70% of the ceiling, we reduce the efficiency of the types of cooling by around 30%. Okay, it's good, but here it's just the efficiency. What about thermal comfort? In fact, according dealing with thermal comfort, it's a little bit more difficult because there is even less paper which deals with this question. I found some of them which were very interesting. For example, 2 years ago, Ecofon made a study in the WUPA tower. I think this study will be presented later by my colleague. Well, they observed that covering 50% of the ceiling with acoustic panel leads to an increase of operative temperature of 0.3 degree. Just to remind that operative temperature is one measure of the thermal comfort. It's not the measurement of thermal comfort, but it's one hint on the thermal comfort. We found also some other paper, scientific articles where with field measurement or lab experiment, but it was always very difficult to compare because it's very different situation, different buildings, different ways to measure. And we just saw that we can observe an increase of the operative temperature up to 2 degrees. It's a lot, but it's not so representative because it was very difficult to compare. Just to try to give new element on this topic, I can just say that we are running a new experiment in Germany in a new building, and we hope to obtain new results on this question. Just some hints from the literature review, something I have found by reading the paper, that some authors said that increasing the perimeter gap, it's just the distance between the vertical wall and the acoustic panel. In fact, it's this distance. Increasing the perimeter gap around the acoustic element may allow better access to the thermal mass, so it may be better for the exchange with the ceiling. If possible, acoustic element axis should be perpendicular to windows. If you have long ways of acoustic panel, maybe it's better to put them perpendicular to the windows. It's better also to distribute the acoustic element on the ceiling all over, rather than clustering everything in the center of the ceiling. Of course, here we are just in a thermal point of view. If you close everything in the center of the ceiling, it's maybe worse than distributing everything. And the lower the emissivity, the higher the efficiency reduction. Just to remind that the emissivity is the ability of a surface, characterize the ability of a surface to exchange heat by radiation with the surroundings. These are just some effects done in the literature, but which has to be confirmed by new experiments. It was just to give you a literature overview of the results. Having some measurements, it's good, but it's even better to be able to predict everything, of course. And so, of course, there is already a lot of tools which are able to model the thermal behavior of building. Here, I just took some of them. We have COMSOL, Energy Plus, ESPR, Transys, and many others. In my study, I just tried to work with Transys. Transys, what it is? In fact, it's a simulation software which is used to model the thermal behavior of building. You give to Transys the building parameters, the surface of each wall, the position of glazing, the type of glazing, the thermal bridges, the ventilation and filtration. You give to Transys the gains, so the occupancy, the equipment, the activity in the building, and also some weather data. And thanks to all this data, Transys will be able to compute the building thermal performance, so the temperature of air in each room of this building, but also the heating and cooling load, and also the thermal comfort inside your building. It's a simulation software, so it helps you to study the behavior of the building. The problem is that the basic version of trenches does not know how to deal with acoustic panel, because just in trenches it's very difficult to model such kind of surface, of a small surface with a lot of voids around everywhere. So what we did, in fact, we worked on a thermal model of acoustic panel, of acoustic element in buildings for trenches. To do this, we consider, of course, we consider a room here around the panel, and in the center of the room, a panel. We wrote some equations. I will not detail all equations now, but we can discuss about it later. But we consider the difference of temperature between below the panel and above the panel, the characteristics, the emissivity, the surface, all the effect, and we try to include the law for convective and radiative exchange between the panel and the surroundings. All these elements are put in the model, and the goal of this model is just to really model the impact of acoustic panel on the type of building, on the thermal behavior of type of building. So as I said, we modeled the radiative and convective exchange, and we made two assumptions, just to precise this. The first assumption was is that the panels are clustered together in the center of the room. So it's not possible in our model to work with different layouts of panel. We can't play with this. We are just, in the model point of view, we are just clustering all the panels in the center of the room. And another assumption is that the vertical wall temperature may be presented by a kind of average temperature which depends on the temperature of each vertical element. In fact, this is an assumption which is required to model the radiative exchange. In this model, requires two kinds of inputs. The first one, the first inputs comes from trenches, the multi-zone building. It's the surface temperature, the air temperature. And from the user, of course, we need to know the ceiling coverage ratio, the acoustic panel, and some room properties. And from this model, giving this element to the model, you can compute the radiative and convective effect of the panel in the room and in the building. And of course, also, what I call a new operative temperature, it's the impact of your acoustic panel on the thermal comfort in the room. Well, here, just a view, just to show the things. Here we have a view of trenches. It's basic case of trenches, and we just included here the model in a new type, a new plugin for trenches, which is here, which communicates with the building and which is able to output the operative temperature, so the level of comfort, and also the effect of acoustic panel on the thermal behavior of building. Making a model is good. Making a model which is correct with the reality, it's better, of course. So it's important to validate this. And to validate, I just took my previous graph. Here we have all, it's exactly the same as previous with the line. And I tried to represent a very simple case according to my model, a very small room with, and I tried to vary the ceiling coverage ratio. And here we obtained the red points, which are modeling results. So what can we see? We can see that we have a good correlation between the experiment and the model, which is good. We are very happy of this, of course. But it's also a very general view. As I said before, here on my graph, we have all the data from all layout, all case, all distance of to the ceiling. So here, this model allows to predict just the global, the overall behavior of the acoustic panel on thermal comfort and on TAB's cooling efficiency. We talk about cooling efficiency. What about thermal comfort? In fact, if I play with my model, I can see that this new model allows to, when we increase the ceiling coverage ratio, we observe an increase in the operative temperature of 0.3 degrees for 50% ceiling coverage ratio. If you remind, it's close to the first measurement done in the WUPA tower, but it's the lower limit of measurement. Some other experimental papers show that we can observe some higher effect. So I think for the next step of this work, it will be important to validate this part of thermal comfort with new measurement. And just to conclude, because it's the end of the 2 minutes, of the additional 2 minutes, I would like just to remind that, of course, acoustic panel help to improve the acoustic comfort in tab building. According to measurements in literature, it reduces the tab efficiency, and it impacts also the acoustic comfort. To be able to predict this, we made a thermal model of acoustic panel in a new Transys plugin, and this model is a transient model which includes radiative and convective effect, and it allows to very well reproduce the effect of acoustic panel on tabs efficiency. The next step for me of this work will be just to distribute this plugin freely. I would say just to have your comment, your feeling, your criticism, but also, and just to give your opinion on this model. And of course, we will compare the results of this new model with the new measurement we are running in a building in Germany, just to try to improve the thermal comfort part of this model. Well, thank you for your attention.